If you have a beard and you're trying to be safe in your shop, these dust masks, and you know, they even have the cheaper ones, which are even worse. You may have already thought about it, and it's going to stop anything big from getting in your lungs, but that's not the stuff that's going to hurt you. It's the really fine dust, the stuff you almost can't even see. That's where it's going to get you. So when you're breathing in through one of these and you have a beard, all around the sides, you're getting those fine particles. They're getting in you. So I have been looking around trying to find a way to have some actual dust filtration without shaving. And everything I found was really expensive. So here's a little idea I had, and you may think this is kind of out there, but it seems to work good, and I thought I'd share it.
I started looking online, and you know, some of these things are over $1,000 and are, you know, $500, $600, $800. About the cheapest I could find, I was seeing something on eBay like, you know, $300 or $400, but just really expensive. Here's a little shot I did in my shop, but I turned off the lights so you can just see the dust and the highlighted there. But where this project started is I had a family member who had sleep apnea, and they had their issues corrected surgically, so they had a CPAP machine they were no longer using. And I asked if I could try it out, and they had no use for it. And let me take it. So I kind of got mine for free, but I bet you could find one on Craigslist, or maybe you know somebody that has one. Maybe their insurance company's replaced it with a newer model. You know, something like that.
Now here's what I'm starting with. I got lots of parts. Extra seals for the mask. Bunch of the little microfine filters. DVD with some instructions, a couple of bags of stuff, the actual CPAP machine. Here's a complete mask and hose. Got extra hoses, complete extra mask in there. More seals, more extra parts and filters. A bunch of stuff there. Here's a score I got from work. They had some old shelving and cabinets, workbench type stuff they were throwing away. And these metal shelf or metal drawer units, I've got quite a few of them actually. This one has four. And what I'm looking at is these sections are all bolted together independently. So you can take them apart and reconfigure them in any stack or side by side.
And as I suspected, these drawer units do come apart.
There was a bunch of screws and stuff holding them together, but you can take them apart and make them individual drawers.
Here's where I do my grinding. And this grinder flips over to the left as well for horizontal grinding.
So I want my drawer to be in this area here. That way it can work for either the vertical or the horizontal grinding. And I think I could take one of these drawer units apart by itself and mount it underneath my bench. And inside it, this thing's got a big old power supply. It has a spot inside where you can add water so you're not breathing really dry air. It's supposed to be better for you, I think. Your hose connections right here on the front. I think I'm going to put this in the drawer all the way up. I'm going to put a hole right here in the front of this drawer. So, should be able to open the drawer, you know, reach in, turn the unit on, then slide the drawer back under the bench where it stays out of the dust. And
I have to figure out a way to store the mass too, so I haven't planned that far yet.
All right, there it is mounted under the bench.
Be easy to get to. Like I said, we'll reach in and turn it on. Close it when you're grinding. And I don't think it'll have any dust problems.
All right, there's the first hole in my drawer. This is the power plug. That'll come out through the back and down behind the bench and be plugged in. I'm gonna make kind of a homemade grommet here so there's no chafing on that cord. Here's a kind of a cheap way to do a grommet. It's probably not, you know, correct. If you're doing this in a business or something, you'd probably be in trouble, but build up quite enough layers of electrical tape there that when you put it in the hole, it's a really snug fit into the hole where it doesn't even want to go through there. I center that tape on there. Take two zip ties, put one on each side, really, you know, cinch down tight as you can. Trim the tails off. And that puppy ain't going nowhere. I gotta put a hole in the front of this drawer where your air supply comes out. And this is a flat bottom drawer, it's sitting flat on the bench, so I can no, I want it to come out about there. So I can just, I'm going to mark my hole right there. And we'll drill it with a unibit. Okay, the alignment's perfect, but the hole's not big enough. I'm gonna have to get a knockout set or something. I was digging through my toolbox and I did find this even larger unibit, but This hose is kind of an odd size, so even with that bigger unibit, still gonna come up short. So what I'm discovering is your regular hole knockouts, like we use in electric industry. It's gonna be a little bit too big, but that's the closest I've got. You may have seen these before. You can buy these sets. This is a Greenlee set. Cutter goes on the inside. A little bit to spare, but it's fine. I think it's going to work just fine. I'm still trying to figure out how I'm going to store the mask. You know, I don't want it to get dirty and stuff when I'm not using it. I was digging through this box of supplies. I noticed there's a couple of different, there's a nice drawstring bag. I'm guessing that's probably made to maybe to store that in. Maybe like if you're traveling or something. I don't know. But I That would definitely keep it clean when you weren't using it. Well, I just measured the hose on this thing. It's a little over 5 feet, so I'm centered on my grinder. I can go, you know, 5 feet that way. I can my workbench 8 feet long, and I can reach almost all the way to the other end. And I think what I'm going to do to store the mask, this bag is seals it up good. I think I'm just going to hang it up here on my bench. It's out of the way. You know, so here's how I picture myself using this. I'm going to come out to grind. I'm going to pull the mask out of the bag. Open the drawer. Here's the power button. I don't know if you can hear it on the camera, but the thing's blowing air. You know, don the mask and go to work. When you're done, you know, turn it off, stow it back in the bag. The unit has a filter on it, and it's going to be protected from the majority of the dust just from the fact it's in that drawer. And now there's plenty of airflow to that drawer. There's no bottom in that, the carcass to the drawer unit. And I think it's going to work good.